Hello from the American National Standards Institute, and welcome to this video about piping and instrumentation diagrams. In this video, we will first discuss what piping and instrumentation diagrams are. Second, the importance of piping and instrumentation diagrams in the workplace. Third, what ANSI ISA 5.1 covers. Fourth, how to read a piping and instrumentation diagram. And fifth, symbolism covered in ANSI ISA 5.1. In many industries, like oil and gas, engineers create a blueprint for equipment and control layout. This blueprint is called a piping and instrumentation diagram and is fundamental to every standardized engineering project. A piping and instrumentation diagram is essentially a schematic illustration that shows the functional relationship between piping, instrumentation, and equipment components in a process system. Process control instrumentation includes control valves, actuators, transmitters, and other devices that automatically adjust variables like flow rates, chemical concentrations, mixing speeds, and more. Piping and instrumentation diagrams can often be confused with process flow diagrams. A process flow diagram shows the connectivity and relationships between the main equipment and units of a process, while a piping and instrumentation diagram typically includes more information about piping, controllers, and valves than a process flow diagram. Additionally, piping and instrumentation diagrams do not contain operational specifications that process flow diagrams do, such as flows and stream compositions. Essentially, a process flow diagram is a simplified version of a piping and instrumentation diagram. Through a piping and instrumentation diagram, you can get information like the mechanical and electrical details, with names and numbers of a given system or process, all valves and their identifications, piping information such as sizes and material specifications, flow directions, the connection types from the controllers to the field devices, control inputs and outputs, and more. Industries such as chemical, petroleum, power generation, metal refining, pulp and paper, and numerous other continuous batch discrete part processing and material handling industries require the use of control system schematics, functional diagrams, and electrical schematics, which are mapped out in piping and instrumentation diagrams. These specialized charts are important for problem identification and solving. It also helps assure that facilities, such as any plant, manufacturing area, lab, or commercial factory, keeps running smoothly. As such, nearly every facility should have piping and instrumentation drawings. Depending on the particular industry, there are a plethora of instrumentation and control systems which aid efficiency and productivity of production equipment. Some of the essential process control instrumentation systems include level control and monitoring, pressure control and monitoring, automated control systems, temperature control and monitoring, and supervisory control and data acquisition. ANSI ISA 5.1 establishes uniform means of depicting and identifying instruments or devices. It covers inherent functions, systems, and applications of instruments used for measurement, monitoring, and control. The American National Standard defines instrumentation as a collection of instruments, devices, hardware, or functions or their application for the purpose of measuring, monitoring, or controlling an industrial process or any combination of these. ANSI ISA 5.1 details that instrumentation is often assembled into systems for various reasons such as ease of purchase, ease of application, and compatibility. And these systems may need to be identified on drawings and in text. The standard provides a list of some of the more common instrumentation systems and the system codes often used to identify them. ANSI ISA 5.1 enables anyone reading a flow diagram who has a reasonable amount of plant knowledge to understand the measurement and control of the process. As such, the symbols and identification methods set forth in this standard serve as conceptualizing aids, design tools, teaching devices, and concise and specific means of communication in all types of technical, engineering, procurement, construction, and maintenance documents. This includes but is not restricted to instrumentation and control on piping and instrumentation diagrams, functional diagrams, binary logic diagrams, electrical schematics, and loop diagrams. ANSI ISA 5.1 is suitable for use whenever any reference to an instrument is required in the chemical, petroleum, power generation, air conditioning, metal refining, and numerous other industries. Understanding how to read a piping and instrumentation diagram effectively requires familiarity with standard instrument symbols and standard identification letter codes, also known as tag numbers. Instrumentation symbols represent the equipment in the process. They are graphical representations of components in a process system, such as a centrifugal pump, vacuum pump, gear pump, controller, control valve, pressure indicator control, flow control valve, converter, condenser, furnace, boiler, motor, reducer, separator, actuator, and much more. These standardized symbols in a piping and instrumentation diagram are used to record and display measurements, and ultimately play a crucial role in helping industry professionals. All the instruments in a piping and instrumentation diagram are marked by a circle with an assigned tag number, the identification letter code. The tag number helps in identifying the device and is essential for referencing components during design, troubleshooting, and maintenance. Identification letter codes refer to a sequence of letters or numerals, or both, used to designate an individual instrument, function, or loop. They help with grouping all equipment into a three-letter or less abbreviation. Sometimes you will use more letters, but 2 to 3 letters cover the vast majority of use cases. For example, FCV refers to flow control valve, FIT refers to flow indicating transmitter, LAL refers to level alarm low, TSV refers to temperature safety valve, PSE refers to pressure rupture disc, and XV refers to on-off valve. As you can note, the first letter of the code represents the parameters that are being controlled, monitored, or measured, such as A for analysis, F for flow, P for pressure, T for temperature, etc. The second letter defines the type of control device being used, for example, C for control, I for indicator, T for transmitter, V for valve, etc. Further letters designate the function of the component and modify the meaning of the preceding letters. The instruments in a piping and instrumentation diagram are marked with the tag number in a circle, with the presence or absence of a line in the circle. This line determines the location of the physical device. Let's take a look at how these are commonly represented. No line in the circle means that the instrument is located in the field near the process and operator. A solid line means that the instrument is located in a control room, accessible to the operator. A dotted line means that the instrument is not directly accessible. To represent an instrument with a shared control and display system, take the tag number and draw a square around it. This indicates that the instrument can now be accessed remotely in a distributed control system. The piping or connection lines on the piping and instrumentation diagram give information about the associations between instruments, meaning how the instruments connect to each other and the type of signal being transmitted. For example, a solid line indicates the interconnection is via pipework, while a dotted line indicates an electrical connection. Here is an example of how to read a piping and instrumentation drawing from what we just discussed. These specific diagrams are adapted from Table 13. And Table 23 of ANSI ISA 5.1 2024 and are examples of how to read instrumentation symbols, specifically a self-actuated final control element symbol. ANSI ISA 5.1 provides symbol sets for the graphic depiction of a limited or total functionality of instruments and devices, entire monitor or control loops, or control circuits. The standard maintains that sufficient symbols should be used to show the functionality of the instrumentation and/or control loop being depicted. Piping and instrumentation symbols are representative of the functional relationship between piping, instrumentation, and system equipment units. The symbols are standard shapes that are categorized according to their functions and industrial uses. The main categories of piping and instrumentation symbols are as follows: valve, pump, piping, instrumentation, vessels, heat exchangers, and equipment symbols. There is a wide variety of symbols depending on industry and manufacturer. Luckily, standards like ANSI-IS A5.1 serve as a conceptualizing aid, library, and teaching device for understanding the specific means of communication and technical applications for piping and instrumentation graphical symbols. If your workplace is seeking to adhere to ANSI ISA 5.1 specifications for instrumentation systems and equipment used for measurement and control, you can find the standard on the ANSI web store.